There's probably a couple of ways to describe when the best time to apply nitrogen is. Firstly, if you think about it from the plant point of view, it's really requiring most of that nitrogen later in its growth. It's not at the early stages. So in an ideal world, we'd be applying a lot of that nitrogen during stem elongation. The reality, if we haven't got lots of rain events during that time, is we can't get nitrogen on efficiently. So it's really about applying nitrogen earlier at the right amounts. In terms of timing the nitrogen application, it depends on the actual products that are being used. If it's urea that's being spread, the best case is to provide it just before a rain event to get it incorporated and to also have the moisture there for the plant to respond to. Over the last 3 years, we've been trying to look at the impact of different time of application of urea for the wheat crop, where we've looked at in fallow, at planting, and also as an in-crop top-up. In general, we've been struggling to show too much difference in the response between those timings. The reason seems to be that the nitrogen movement down the soil profile has been much slower and more limited than expected. And particularly once the crop's in the ground, if the nitrogen's still in that top 5, 10, 15 centimetres, that's the area that keeps drying out. And so the nitrogen is basically sitting in those zones and not being pushed deep down with water movement. When you're trying to determine the best time to apply nitrogen in northern New South Wales, southern Queensland, there's a lot of factors involved. And strangely enough, sometimes that could be the price of nitrogen at various times during the year. It's trying to fit it into your farming operations where it's more convenient, because certainly what we've seen, there's no perfect timing to apply it. So it's more trying to fit it into your program at a suitable time and where the costs are limited.